last restaurant is Kelsey's choice. Kelsey and her husband love coffee, and they're always on the hunt for the perfect cup. She says she found that and a whole lot more in this woman-owned restaurant. This is Fair Trade Café.
The Fair Trade Café is so much more than a coffee house providing specialty, sustainable coffee. We are a gathering space. We're an art gallery. We're an eatery. The menu really is just an eclectic curation of some really just hearty favorites. We have anything from a non-traditional breakfast burrito to a truffled grilled cheese and soups and stuffed croissants. So the vibe of the cafe is similar to the menu. It really is eclectic. It's comfy, it's cozy, yet it's super chic in certain places. Every month we have a local artist that's featured, and if you take a look around, love it, buy it, support our artists. However, know that in a month it's gonna be rotated. I'm a former educator, and I had gone on a trip to Costa Rica, and I did some touristy things, and on the last day I went to a coffee plantation. And the teacher in me did a little research, and I learned that it's the second highest traded commodity next to oil. It's the second highest purchased beverage next to water. And then it's extremely exploitative to our people and to the earth. So I just thought, you know, there's gotta be something else. And I'm a look, see, move kind of woman. So 16 years later, here we are in the Fair Trade Cafe, and I proudly only serve fair trade and direct trade certified coffees and teas. We are the longest standing coffee house here in downtown Phoenix. We've been here 16 strong years, and I really think it's the community support. We love them and they love us, and this is beautiful like ecosystem of just love, and it's created a successful business.
So Kelsey, how did you find Fair Trade, and what is your favorite thing to get there?
So my husband and I did some Googling to find local coffee places in the area and came across Fair Trade, and we said, well, let's just try it out. We've never been to this place before, so him and I went, and what an experience. We walk in, everybody says hi to you, and it's very welcoming. So when I go, I get the Phoenix cold brew. It's their signature cold brew. And it has agave and cinnamon on top of it. It kind of tastes like a churro.
Ooh.
So it's creamy, but not too creamy that you can't taste the coffee still. So it's nice and smooth when you drink it.
That blend is great.
It is.
I love cold brew too.
I usually get the Phoenix, but this time I decided I was going to try their flight. It's not on their menu, but I saw on Instagram that they posted about it, and they come in like little glasses, fancy glasses, and there's three of them. So one of them is a soy base with agave and cinnamon on top of it with sea salt. And then the next one would be an agave with your choice of milk, which I got almond milk, and it comes with amaretto and white chocolate in it.
Mm-hmm.
It was very orange forward, but it was good orange forward.
Nice.
And then the Phoenix is the other one that's on there.
That's the one you love.
That's the one that I love. I was so happy that one was on there.
Now, you go there for the coffee, but yes, you stay for the food.
Yes.
I thought that was amazing. What do you eat when you're there?
So typically we go for breakfast, but this time we went for lunch. And for breakfast, I usually get their jalapeno and cheddar sandwich, breakfast sandwich with egg whites I get. But this time I got the truffle grilled cheese sandwich.
Ooh.
It's got sun-dried tomatoes on it with truffle oil and cheese. It was you pull apart and you got the nice string in between it. And I got a side salad with it that had cranberries and almonds and a really nice light balsamic vinaigrette on top of it.
Right. So Frank, what did you have when you were there?
So I went with my wife for lunch. I had the Cuban. Cuban was great. It had the nice pickle on it. Now, it said it was on a panini or whatever kind of bread, but it was more of a focaccia.
Yeah.
And I kind of liked it for focaccia because it was real buttery. The regular Cuban is more flat.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And
yeah,
so I kind of liked it on a focaccia, even though it wasn't like a real Cuban per se, yeah, like Miami, but it was excellent. I would say it's a nice place if you're in the area to stop.
Marii, what did you have?
I also had the Phoenix, and we went for breakfast. My person had one of their chocolate mochas.
Mm-hmm.
It was delicious. Had the same sandwich on the jalapeno bagel with egg and cheddar and tomato.
Egg whites, regular eggs?
I had regular eggs.
You did? Okay.
Yeah.
Cheddar,
yeah,
and tomato.
Cheddar and tomato.
So
and
tell me about the bagel, because I'm a bagel fanatic.
Really nice crust outside, soft inside. Even though it was jalapeno, it didn't have too hot of a flavor, just a really good jalapeno taste without being too spicy.
That's really great, because jalapenos, they should add boldness and not just tear your mouth apart.
Exactly.
Right? You're nodding. You had it too?
Yes, that's awesome. What it does.
And what else do you have?
I also had their pumpkin bread that has a little bit of chocolate chips in it, and it has this real warm kind of winter spices that you would expect, cinnamon, maybe a little nutmeg.
How's that texture?
It was delicious. It's moist, but not gooey.
Oh, I like
it. It's a wonderful quick bread.
I've had that before as well. I've had their pumpkin and their banana bread, and the banana bread is really good too. It's very good if you, I dunked it just to try it in with the Phoenix to see, because sometimes people dip it in their hot coffee. I wanted to see what it tasted like in my cold. It was good.
Oh,
the
good.
Banana one.
It would, oh, that's really cool. I would do that.
Different.
So this is your place. How would you describe the atmosphere?
It's very laid back. It's very mellow, industrial. The lighting in it is really cool. They used, it looks like parts of crane anchors to it with the light bulbs and everything. There's couches. It's inside, outside seating, pretty much wherever you want to sit.
Great artwork.
Feel comfortable. Yes, they use local artwork on the walls. That's up for sale.
So anything you took away from the atmosphere first time?
It was very cozy,
yeah,
relaxing, and it seemed like the staff knew a lot of the patrons that were there. We were there around noon, and they were just hanging out and having a good, relaxing time. Overall, very calming environment.
When I went there, also, there was about 20 people in line. Yeah, and yes, the staff knew them, and they're like calling to them. And I just pretended like they were calling me, and I cut in line. No, I didn't. I did not do that. So, Kelsey, this is your place. Pro tip or takeaway?
Pro tip is don't be afraid to try something new. Don't be afraid to ask the people who work there what their recommendations are. They could give you a little hint, like trying their flight. It's not mentioned on their menu, but if you go and follow them on Instagram, they have a lot of different tips and stuff on there.
That pop up. The secret menu.
The secret menu.
I love that. Marii, any pro tips?
Just it was a very comfortable, very happy, easygoing place. It was really nice.
I like that. Frank, pro tips.
I'd say a must try is the balsamic dressing. The balsamic dressing was excellent. Ooh,
very cool. Mm-hmm. If you want to try Fair Trade Cafe, it's located downtown Phoenix near Roosevelt and Central. An average check is $15, and they do take reservations.